Welcome back to the channel. I apologize for not uploading last week. I'm in the last semester of school right now, and last week and this week are finals week, and I'm really trying to just finish strong. But that brings me to today's video. Last week I was able to get some footage during golden hour down at the river, and it sparked an idea of why not talk about the things that I love about my car and the things that I hate about my car. I drove this car for about 10,000 miles so far, so I know a few ins and outs of the car, what's good about it, what's bad about it, if you should get it, if you shouldn't get it. So these are a few things that I love and hate about my car. So right off the bat, let's start with this grill. As you know, this is a custom grill that I made myself. I love the look of this grill, I love it. If you haven't seen this grill, or if you wanna figure out how to make this grill, check out this video right up here. I show you how I did it, I show you the process, anything you're gonna need. The week after I redid my grill and made it super nice, like really nice, I parked in South Philadelphia. It pissed me off so much. And a van tried to squeeze into a spot in front of me and just basically destroyed the grill. The paint's ruined in the bottom corner. The grill is pushed in. You could see how bad it is, and you just squeeze in. It's the culture in South Philly. It sucks, but what are you gonna do? So that's the grill on my car. The next thing I love about my car are these wheels, these Method wheels. They didn't come this color. If you saw the last video, you can see that I painted them. They look super good. They look like they came this way, and I am in love with the new color. Originally, these wheels didn't look so good to me because of the outer grooves that surround the whole wheel, but they grew on me, and I am in love with these wheels. And the Hankook tires on them, they're low pro, so it just gives them such an aggressive look, in my opinion. The next thing about my car are these Rally Armor mud flaps. These are the universal mud flaps, so I didn't get brackets or any clips. I just ordered the universal ones for about 30 bucks, and then ordered a pack of universal clips off of Amazon and just pressed them in, and they're staying. I find it silly that people would spend $130 on a set of Rally Armor mud flaps that honestly might not even fit the car that they say they'll fit. My brother got the kit for his car and the brackets don't even fit. You hear them flapping all the time. So 30 bucks for these. If you want to figure out how I did that as well, check out the video right up there. The next little thing that I love about my car is this little decal. I believe his name is Sasuke. For a while I was big into watching Eliminate's channel, and they always get these little stickers, so they inspired me to get that sticker, and I think it looks super dope on the back of my car. Another thing that I love about my car is the spoiler. I raised it just a little bit. Super easy modification to do. I also made a video about it right up here, so check that out. I basically love all the modifications I did to my car. This modification, the side skirt modification, that was probably the biggest modification to my car. On the sport models, they come with the side skirts, but for a lot of people who have the base model, they don't have these side skirts. So you have to modify your car a bit to put these on, and you could see that in this video. It was pretty crazy, but I think they look awesome on the car. Everyone always asks me, why are you doing like all these little modifications, and why are you drilling into your car and stuff like that? You're not gonna be able to resell it. And here's the thing, before I even got into modifying my car, I wanted to keep this car forever. And when I'm done with it, when I'm done paying it, when I get a new car, I'd lend it to people, stuff like that. I don't plan on selling this car. So why not make it look how I want it to look? Another thing that people don't really talk about is the gas mileage that this car gets. It's really good on gas. It is a manual, so you lose a little bit of gas because you're constantly like just doing pulls, even though the car is kind of slow. But it does well on gas, and that is something that I am very appreciative of, because I don't feel like filling up all the time. That's one of the reasons, not the major reason, but that's one of the reasons why I didn't get a WRX. The major reason is because they are expensive as So those are the things that I love about my car. And before I get to the things that I hate about this car, I want to talk about something that people ask me a lot on Instagram, is how fast is this car? It's not that fast, but in the first two gears, if you know how to do a nice pull, it's quick. It jumps off the line. Once you get high in gears, it's not really that quick or fast. But here's a little video of how fast it is, or slow. Cup half empty or half full, however you want to look at it. Check this out. So there is the speed of my car. Now let's segue into what I hate about this car. There are three things that I hate about this car. First thing is, no matter how often I wipe down the dashboard, the next 2 days it will fill up with dust. It is insane how fast this car gets dusty. I don't know if it's just like me, if I'm just a dusty guy and I just shed a lot of dust, but this car just fills up with dust all the time. Does that happen to normal cars? I don't know, but let me know if that happens to normal cars. Also, in the same area where it gets dusty, there's constantly squeaking noises. It sounds like something isn't quite tightened all the way in the dash in the middle portion, because when you drive, it makes this squeaky sound that gets so annoying. And sometimes I'll just be driving and I'll like press my hand on it and hold it down just to make it stop squeaking, whatever, I guess. And the last thing that I don't like about my car is Apple Play. I'm not really a fan of Apple Play, and thankfully you don't have to use it. The thing that sucks about Apple Play is when you're plugged in and when you're listening to music, I don't know why, but if you hit a bump, it skips your music, which is like crazy. They might be able to update that in firmware or something, but when you hit a bump, why would it skip your music? It's not like a CD player or a record player, but it does in my car at least. I don't know if that happens in your car with Apple Play, but I think that's insane. So most of the time I don't use Apple Play. And when you plug it in to charge your phone, it automatically switches you to Apple Play. So if you plug in your phone to charge, you can't use Bluetooth to listen to music. You have to use Apple Play to listen to music. That was my video on my love-hate relationship with my 2018 Subaru Impreza. If you have any other questions, just hit me up in the comment section. I will answer you right back. I guarantee it. I will see you next Wednesday. Peace.